this thing?
No, I can cut it out later. Ready? Hey everybody, it's Quicken and welcome back to Tattoo Talk Tuesday. So if it's your first time joining us on Tattoo Talk Tuesday, Tattoo Talk Tuesday is our weekly interactive talk show where we take user submitted questions and I try to lend my experience to you guys. So this week I am really excited to have Josie on the channel. If you've never heard me talk about Josie, you're in for a huge treat because I'm so stoked to have Josie on the channel today. This week, we're going to be straying from the normal, like, viewers sending me questions, and we're going to have a conversation that I've been dying to have with Josie for years. So you're in for a little bit of Josie tattoo talking me today.
Uh-oh.
So I want to first let you introduce yourself and kind of talk about who you are, because
okay.
Some people might not know, but yeah, what's Josie like?
Hey everyone, I'm Josie. I work here at Barnett Fair. I also am co-owners of it. Amanda is awesome. She also works here. Yeah, I don't know what else to say about me.
So where this comes from is I've been, you know, a manatee of Josie. I've been an assistant for Josie for a long time, and with that, there's kind of that like shampoo girl connection where I overhear you talk to a ton of clients. And it's not really eavesdropping because I feel like I need to be in the know. I need to know what's going on.
Yeah, we share clients and everything.
We share clients. Yeah. We share clothes.
Yeah.
So there's this conversation of like, a few summers ago, Josie went on vacation, and when she came back, I overheard her have these conversations with clients about experiences you had in Cuba. So Josie went to Cuba a few years ago, and correct me if I'm wrong, was it like around the time where Americans could legally enter?
It was. It was right around the time where there was like a couple approved ways that you could go to Cuba. There was like either through tour groups or through educational purposes, things like that. I didn't go through that way. So every year around January, February, I go to Mexico with a couple of my friends who go there all the time. They got married down there and they love it there, so I tag along with them. And I also hate the winter time, so
yeah.
I try to get away a little bit. So this year, or the 2 years past, I think it was 2016?
I think it was two summers ago.
It was probably, yeah, two winters ago.
Okay, yeah.
We went to Mexico. We usually fly into Cancun, and when we fly into Cancun, we work our way down the coast. We just rent a car, stop in every town, and just hang out, see if we like it. If not, we're on to the next.
Mm-hmm.
So this year we decided that we were going to try to go to Cuba because we've always wanted to go, and we heard that there was an easier way. If you fly into Cancun, it's only about like a 40-minute flight from Cancun, and all you have to do is buy this like $25 visa that you get at the airport, and then you can go there. They don't really ask any questions or anything. You just go, and then when you come back, they stamp the visa. They don't stamp your passport.
Okay.
Again, it's not the way that you're supposed to do it, but I think they're pretty lenient now, so it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, if somebody told you that's how to do it, then...
Yeah. Like, we had prepared paperwork,
mm-hmm.
So we prepared paperwork where we were like, in case somebody asked, we were going on behalf of a blog. There was this like vintage motorcycle blog that had sponsored us, so we had that paperwork just in case.
Okay, but really when you got there, there were no questions?
They didn't ask any questions. They were just like, how long are you gonna be here? We told them, they said, do you have a place to stay? We actually got a place on Airbnb.
I think that's crazy too.
Yeah.
So you could go on Airbnb and reserve that in Cuba.
Yeah, and Airbnb takes American credit cards, so you can do that. Because in Cuba, you can't use American credit cards. You can't use credit cards at all. You can't use your telephone. You can't use Wi-Fi unless there's certain designated areas.
Okay.
So.
So...
So you decided to go to Cuba. When you went, were there other like Americans too? Were Americans like one of the last few people who could go into Cuba, or the year you went, other tourism could occur in Cuba too?
Yes, so there's been people going to Cuba for years and years. There's like cruise ships that dock into Cuba. Okay. There's like all kinds of tourism there. There's like beautiful hotels and everything for people to stay.
Okay.
It was just restricted to only certain, you could only, if you were American, again, I'm not a historian or anything, I don't know all of the legal things, but the way that it seemed to me was that if you had an approved reason to go there, you could go there. But for tourism reasons, you were not allowed to go there.
Okay.
If you were an American. So, of course, there were Americans that went there. Like the friend that I went with, she went there 10 years before I did.
Okay.
And she just went with a bunch of photography equipment, and they let her in. She stayed with a family there and went around Cuba.
That's awesome.
So there's been people, there's like people from Europe who go there, there's cruise ships, there's tons of tourism already there, like people who are going there.
Okay.
So I think what I found most interesting with the, you know, the eavesdropping, the conversations I overheard between you and clients.
What else did you hear?
I know, I'm listening, I'm always listening. If they're thirsty, I know. So I think what was interesting, you know, your fiance is Mike Ski. You guys on the channel know him. I have a few videos with him. I have a couple tattoos from him. So you guys went, I mean, I think that you are like a fabulous and predominant couple walking around. You're both like 9 feet tall. So you're walking around, he's a tattoo artist, and you guys, I guess, walk past the tattoo shop?
Yeah, so when we got to Cuba, we stayed, it was right on the waterfront. It was this like 4-story walk-up apartment that I guess the guy had a couple apartments in the area. So we settled in, and when you first go to the area, I was a little hesitant because, so we got to the airport. The airport was super small. It was just like this tiny little airport. And then you go outside and there's just like a bunch of old taxi cabs like you see in all the pictures. So we get in the taxi cab, we tell them where we're going, and it was just like insane traffic. And like as soon as we got out, like, and we like smelled the air, we were like, wow, now we know why there's emissions of pools and stuff, because there was just like smog everywhere from all of these like old
vehicles.
So we pulled up to our area, and the guy said that the area was safe, it was nice, it was right on the waterfront was beautiful there. It didn't look the nicest, but only because, so there's all kinds of beautiful like architecture there. There's like Spanish colonial buildings, there's like everything up until the 1950s, and then it seems like it all just kind of like halted, you know? So all of the buildings looked like they were in disrepair. So like first coming in, you assume, you know, being naive or whatever, you're like, maybe this isn't the nicest area. But it was completely fine. And it was walking distance to the touristy area, the downtown area. When we got there, we settled in there, and then we decided to take a walk down to the Old Havana. It's like the center of town. So that's where they have all the beautiful hotels and everything. They have tons of restaurants. And we were walking around and we were surprised that we came across this place. It was called La Marca. Mm-hmm. And we walked in thinking that it was just an art gallery because they had artwork all outside. This is what you get when you wear overalls.
They look cool.
It's like trying to do the little sexy thing, but no. Yeah. All right. So we walk up to this place, and again, the artwork there, even the street art and everything, I think because there is this like sense of change, that the street art there is amazing as well.
Mm-hmm.
And all the art galleries that you go into is just such awesome, inspiring artwork there. So anyway, we walk in, they have this like
in the tile, it's like this beautiful laid out tile that says La Marca on the front. It's so beautiful. And we go in and they just have local artists there showing. So there was a girl behind the counter and we started, I think it was the show that they were showing were different kinds of tattoo machines that were decorated. They were either hand painted or they had like, you know, sculptures coming off of them. And we're like, oh, this is cool. This is a tattoo themed art show. So we asked the lady, we're like, oh, is this a tattoo themed art show just because, or is it, are you guys into tattoos? We were like looking around on the walls and was a lot of tattoo inspired artwork
on like,
the walls.
What's that?
Yeah.
Okay.
tell me more.
yeah.
So then she was like, no, this is actually a tattoo studio as well. And so then there was a spiral staircase that went all the way up. And she was like, I can show you where it is. So we went up the spiral staircase and there's a whole tattoo studio set up on the second floor. It's like in this like loft area and it's beautiful. It looks just like, you know, any tattoo studio, nice tattoo studio that you would see here. Everything was like, you know, they had everything sanitized, like they were doing everything the way they were supposed to do it. I believe when we went in there was maybe four stations set up.
Okay.
Two tattoo artists were working there. And so then Mike started to talk to them and they were curious and they were just like talking shop, you know? and I was just taking it all in. And so then we started to ask them what the story was, if tattooing was legal there, if it had just become legal, because just from walking around, that's the only like shop that was advertising that they were tattooing, you know, and it was like a nice place. It was in the touristy area, so it seemed like it was like legit. You know, we did see some spots that were just like hand-painted signs that were just like a tattoo gun or like some guy's name or something.
Yeah.
And then it was like steps that went down, and so we didn't go into those.
No.
So
I mean, that feels normal.
Yeah.
So you're going in this tattoo shop and Mike is talking shop. What is the, like, so this tattoo shop, I guess, promoted, clean, beautiful, people were literally tattooing while you were there. What is the risk though? Is tattooing legal?
So the way that it was explained to me, and again, I don't know everything about this, like this is just what was told to me when we were there, is that so tattooing in Cuba, and it may have changed by now because a lot of things have changed by now, but when we were there at the time, they were explaining to us that it's a gray area. So it's not legal to tattoo in Cuba, but it's also not illegal to tattoo in Cuba. They call it illegal, like an A, illegal. I'm sure if you say it in Spanish, it sounds way cooler than how I'm saying it. So they said it's a gray area where, I guess, so Raul Castro recently, there was 201 approved entrepreneur like jobs that you could have. Because before they were all just kind of like either government jobs or whatever. So these were more self-employed jobs that you were able to have. So you could partially own restaurants, you could be like taxi driver, all this kind of stuff. Tattooing is not on there.
Okay.
So they run in the risk of being shut down. So there's been times where the guy was explaining to us where he could be, like people could just come in one day, even though he's right in the center of town, he's right in the touristy area, he could be raided, they could take all of their equipment, all of their supplies, and be shut down. And then a couple days would go by and he would have to reopen and resupply and get all his stuff back. He wouldn't get his stuff back from them, but he would just have to get it himself.
Where is he getting supplies from? Because can he get supplies from America?
So I don't think that he can get supplies from America. I think that he told us that
They were saying that you can get supplies from Canada.
Okay.
You can get supplies from other places that can import into Cuba.
Okay.
But you can't get supplies from America unless you actually go to America and
have them on your person.
Yeah, or even like go to Canada, I guess, and have them like in your luggage and bring them back with you. Okay. But then there's other stuff too that goes along with that where it's like, yeah, I'm not exactly sure how it works.
No, I'm not sure either. I've even had friends who like, I was talking to Jessie Preston once and she said that she took a train from America into Canada and she couldn't even bring tattoo supplies from one country to the other. So I can't even imagine.
Yeah, there's so many different, I don't know how that stuff works, so I'm not sure. But I think that I'm pretty sure they were getting stuff from Canada. I think that he was traveling to Canada and bringing stuff back.
So if his shop got raided, it would take a really long time for him to open back up because essentially he would have to go to Canada to get all of these new products and equipment. That could take a really long time.
Yeah, I assume so.
So when you're in Cuba, what is the vibe of like tattoo culture? Is it celebrated? Is it who cares, like Philadelphia, or just walking around with tattoos? Like, were you viewed oddly, like being tattooed models walking around Cuba like you own the place?
I feel like nobody like looked at me like, oh, that's weird that you have tattoos or anything. I know that there was a time where just like here, tattoos were viewed as like, oh, you got them in prison or if you're part of a gang or something.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the young people who were there who are also like artists there, or like working in like nightclubs or musicians and stuff, they had tattoos. I don't know if they got them from that shop or other. I'm sure there's a ton of people who are doing it underground and stuff as well. But no, nobody looked at me differently.
And people with tattoos, they're wearing them in a celebrated way, or they're like a little kind of like, it's a secret that I'm showing you?
Yeah, no, I think they were out in the open with them.
Okay.
There were, when I was there, there were tourists, and even coming back and reading about the place and stuff, like it seems like they're on Yelp, like they have Yelp reviews and stuff. Like I just looked it up just now and there was like 4 Google reviews for it and stuff. I think that it's like a tourist destination as well because it is right in the touristy area. So a lot of tourists are going there and they see that it's like clean and nice and mm-hmm. pretty. So they want to go and support and get a tattoo in Cuba. From what I saw, there were a lot of tourists there too coming and getting tattoos.
So I guess they're willing to take the risk. They're willing to like have this like quasi-illegal tattoo shop and open it and run it well, and then if anything happens. Did he say anything like that he runs that risk or that like he's scared every day?
They did say that there was that risk. But it's weird because I feel like there is that risk, but at the same time they seem to be celebrated as well, where it's a place that it's like right in the center of town and they have government sponsored art shows there as well. So it's weird. I don't really understand it fully.
Maybe it's like if anyone ever stops by and asks questions, no, we're an art gallery.
Yeah, I guess that's how it works. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
It seems like there's no. So even from reading about it coming back, because I'm like, oh, this sucks that they have to be like this. Like, anyone who is doing something that they love runs a risk of, like, you know, being shut down or something. So I was, like, reading about it and doing research, and it seems like there's no way to make tattooing legal either, unless it's, like,
unless the government one day adopts it as a job you can legally have,
yeah.
A profession. So until Cuba accepts like tattooing as a profession, it will stay illegal?
Illegal.
Illegal.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's really crazy. Well, do you have any final thoughts?
Again, this was just like my experience going to Cuba and seeing, so I'm hoping that things will change down there. And I'm not sure if everything that I said was fully correct. Again, it's just my experience.
I mean, I'm so happy to have you on here to finally like share this conversation with me, because these are the conversations I'd rather have and share with you guys as well, because it's your firsthand experience and it's not like fully researched. It's what you took from your experience and you brought to me and you brought to us. And I think that that's really cool.
Yeah, and I loved my time down there. It was a beautiful country. It was an amazing country. The people there were great. I would go back again.
You're the only person I know who's ever been to Cuba.
So I would tell people to go there, you know, and see it. I have a feeling that it's going to change quite a bit, if it hasn't already, since I've been there. But change is a coming. And so,
yeah, and I wanted to have you on and have this conversation sooner than later, because I do worry about like Americans' abilities to travel to countries like this too. So it was cool that like you went to Cuba and people in Cuba were like, tell your friends and definitely visit, and Americans are cool.
Yeah.
So that's cool. And it's cool that Mike and you could go to the shop and talk shop, and the guy was like, hey Mike, come on in.
Yeah, they were great there. I know there was like a couple other, again, like coming back, I saw there was like some news articles written about it, and there was like some like TV channels who did stuff about it too. So like they're definitely getting press. So I'm hoping that that gray area will change for them eventually.
Cool.
But it seems like they're doing their thing and they don't care, and it's pretty awesome.
I guess that's what has to happen to make waves.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Josie, so much for coming onto the channel and just talking about your experience. I just thought that it was so cool and something that I definitely wanted to share with everybody as well. If you guys have any comments or experience with this topic, definitely leave your comments or questions down below. I had no idea that there were places where tattooing was seen as illegal or illegal or not even considered a legal profession. So I thought, you know, if it only took you 40 minutes from your vacation to get to Cuba where there are rules like that, I thought that that was really interesting. So definitely leave your feedback. Thank you so much, Josie, for coming onto the channel. You can follow Josie on social. Her Instagram handle is JosieOutlaw1, and you can follow our salon as well, Barnett Fair. That's where we're filming today, so thanks for letting us film in Barnett.
Yeah, of course.
And until next time, thank you guys so much, and see ya.